another one of those things I think, how the hell have I just noticed that? I go up and down there most days, right by the marina, and I missed a gigantic birdhouse. Scouting locations for the next documentary. Successful, permission to film, so that's nice. They're going to let me film and do part of my next documentary in there. Very friendly people as well, which is nice. Next job. Excuse the voice. So here we are, 3 a.m. He's like, stop waking me up. 3 a.m. Bedtime soon. I'm trying to ease myself back into a reasonable routine. And I'm going full steam ahead on documentaries, to be honest. Boat episode coming very, very shortly. In fact, I'll include this in this. I'm going full steam ahead. My page growth is minimal with boat things. So my initial plans are coming to light a little bit more now. Now I've got some free time. So this is a bit of fun. I'll give you a preview on the next documentary. That won't take too long, this one, because I've got a lot of the material resourced and researched while I was doing the afternoon tea one. So have a quick snifty little sneak preview. Here you go.
Tango and Cash, Hanky Panky and Ducky Lucky, Batman and Robin, Sherlock and Watson, Jamal and Jermaine, Robin Hood and Little John. Yes, this is the combination famed as fish and chips. Famed throughout the world, everybody visits the country and has to try fish and chips. But why is it so popular and where did it come from? Those ever burning questions. Well, this documentary is going to feature the reason that this humble little notion became a favourable pair.
So yes, there we go. That's the next one. I've got so many documentaries. They're all sort of Victorian Edwardian based. To be honest, when you look at it, the Victorians, don't want to be part of it now, the Victorians created so many things, but the Edwardians, when you try and search YouTube, there's not a lot of documentaries on it. There's a few BBC bits and some Americans that do like Dress Like and this, that and the other, and you know, that kind of thing. But there's not really a lot about the sort of historical facts behind it. So it's another little gap there. I think it deserves a bit of attention. It's my favorite era of many things. So we'll see how it goes. But watch this space. Might change the curtains, actually. Do put the green ones up. We'll have a go at that. So I never really do much in the daytime because usually I was at work and stuff, and when I'm on my days off, God, do I sleep late. So look, it's daylight. Yeah, it's been a few weeks out of work now. My motivation, as I say, was non-existent, but as of today, Sunday, and next week, I've got some bits and pieces to do, and the job I'm going to do next will be the vinyl on these worktops and cupboards. Now, as I showed a while back, I've got this navy blue stuff, so it's going to look pretty good. It's going to be a complete solid block, navy blue. And I think against the gold sink, excuse the cereal bowl. And I'm having to obviously do everything in here at the minute. Still no running water because the pump won't get rid of the air. So I think it'll be nice. There's my water supply in these bottles still. It will be nice in the blue, so that will be a job either Monday or Tuesday. I've got a couple of interviews and phone calls and things to do in the week, but we're getting on with that. So all in all, not a very eventful week. Somebody actually commented on a previous video, oh, you've got black bags under your eyes, etc. You're probably diabetic, you shouldn't drink so much full fat Coke. I'd rather drink the full fat, to be honest, rather than the diet, which has aspartame, which is linked to cancer and all sorts of things. I don't drink that much, to be honest. 2 litre bottles I've collected over time. For this reason, I have no water. So I have to have the bottles of water for that. I'm just sleeping ridiculous clock. I might go to bed at like 4 or 5 a.m. and stuff like that. And I've had a bit of broken sleep as well. So I'm not ill, perfectly fine, perfectly fine. Bit of a cold every now and again, but apart from that, it's fine. Yep, there's a bit of the boat thing because people are saying do something with the daylight, and as it's been daylight, it's getting a bit darker now. Yeah, you get an idea of that. So yeah, not much going on, but as I say, I'm gonna work on this kitchen as of tomorrow. Somebody still needs to come back to cut a few panels that he didn't finish. We'll see how that goes, because he's not heard from him this week. He was meant to let me know. Yeah, when it rains it pours. I'm going to call a pump company, see if they can try and extract the air out of the tank, because weeks and weeks of trying to get the air out and keep doing the resets, which I've just got to push that back in now, it'll come on. It's not doing enough to get the air out, so it is a bit of a problem. I've tried all sorts of different little bits and pieces, but no, it's just not working. So no water, no gas, burner's fine. It's been a challenge, a continuing challenge, but I'm not giving up, not giving up yet. So hopefully more interesting things as of this week. I'm going to get a bit more organised, but it's nice to be able to get in that canopy now and finally have floor space and go in and out without climbing on just stuff. So that's brilliant. In other news, Parsley the dog is obviously that one there. You stay there. See, the eyelid is still a little bit out, but it's not bloodshot. But it appears to be that at the minute, I think he's kind of healed. But it's going to be a wait and see, really, because the last of his tablets and juice is nearly done. So we'll see how it goes. But hopefully positivity. Once these tablets are finished, we'll see a few days after that, as long as it doesn't come back, and he'll be fine. Near 2 months it's taken. 2 months. Yep. What a very nice day today. Very unexpected. It's a quick walk. See what's going on. Not much. It's silent. Not heard it. It's this silent in a long time. And it's a very quiet Sunday. I don't mind that. So I've had my two geese friends. They live over there. And then they come here for food, water supply. So, outside of the boat, as people were saying, there's not enough daytime. Here we go. So obviously down here was the water tank, which is under a mat at the minute, still a bit of a problem. Chimney's back on. Very useful. I've got to change the brackets though, these were temporary, I just had to set. I'm going to switch it around the other way as well. My canopy. Now, one thing I did make the effort yesterday to do, as it was a Saturday and I had literally nothing to go and do, I was very disappointed, is clear it out. I can stand inside. That's very exciting, because up until yesterday I couldn't. Still difficult to film, but I'll give you an idea of where things are. So I've managed to get the bike in nicely, tools hidden behind. I did show this in a previous episode, but obviously now I've got the ground anchor welded on from previous with this, so the bike's not going anywhere. And here we've got my mains fuse board connection. Got my battery drip down there, which is, I touched that a couple of months back by accident, and it flew across the boat. I've got this other chimney bit, I don't know why. Obviously the bedroom is currently sort of down there, that's where the bed is. I've got to work on that. But somebody hasn't contacted me this week, as he said he would. Naughty. So there we go. Let me see if I can get a better angle outside. So it's quite a handy back deck there. Nice space. At the minute it is just storage until all of my stuff can be sorted properly and the works are finished. But there's a nice tall canopy. And here we've got my controls for the motor. Very old school, obviously 1970s, this one. The other thing is, a couple of guys, they bought a boat and they're behind me there. A friend of theirs had some flooring, and this is good home, I think it's B&Q flooring. It's laminate, I can't get to it, but it's a very nice grey wood effect. It's quite realistic for grey wood effect. But I got three packs of that for nothing. They were kind enough to do that for me. Obviously, I flooded out and they said it was going begging, so that's nice. Yeah, this boat's been empty for the whole time I've been here. I think somebody moved in and they lived on it for a while, and according to the words of one resident, they bottled it. I'm going to take a quick walk down here. Yep, all very quiet, lovely. It's late night on a narrowboat, minimal security. Why do I watch this stuff? I'd be looking over my shoulder. It's good watching though. They go to some good properties. Well done them. So the tragic thing is, there's these guys going to these really nice old houses, and some are sort of 1800s and 1900s, Victorian, Edwardian, that kind of thing. And I'm just looking at the furniture and the items left behind, and I'm identifying this, and like from a historical historian point of view, and the old reenactment days, I'm thinking, Christ, some of this stuff's worth a fortune. It breaks my heart. But there's so many things left behind in these houses when they do all these exploratory trips. Christ, I'd love to go into some of these and do a historical thing. Tis I. Yes, more job interviews. We are out and about again. Here we go. Let's see what happens with this one.
How you doing, guys?
Sometimes the best friends you have are nature. True story.
Let me down easy with no big song and dance. No long faces, no long looks. Let the dream begin. Let your darker side give in to the power of the music that I write.
Places, these giant shops and buildings empty than to accept reduced rent, because reducing the rent,
and that is Leeds, my friend, and why I left,
no longer have value. The buildings aren't worth what they say they are.
Remember the good old days when racism and segregation were bad? The London production of a hit US theatre show called Slave Play will hold two so-called blackout performances exclusively for an all-black identifying audience. Set on a plantation in the old American South, the award-winning play explores race, identity, and sexuality. Well, I'll be honest, I look forward to seeing the show on one of the light nights when maybe I'm actually allowed to go. How many
I did my work and finally finished the afternoon tea documentary, which is a relief because the research and everything took months. So it's one of those things, the views will slowly go up in time because you've got to be looking for that subject. But thanks for all the people here that actually looked at it. The likes help it get seen by other people. So the more you like the videos, they get seen by other people. It helps sort of give it a boost and get seen. Next one is fish and chips, the history of, quite an interesting one. And I've got a few others, and there's going to be so many, which is my pages or my channel's progression was always going to be a degree of that sort of historical and hospitality, etc. Obviously, boat people, my membership goes up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. I don't really progress past 2,175 members here. So as far as the boat thing goes, my format's a little bit different for these videos, but it was meant to be a general vlog, and it was just going to be sort of a bit of a mix of things anyway. But thanks for the loyal ones, you know, you keep me going. Gives me a reason to sort of compile, because a lot of these videos, even like this, can take a long time to edit and, you know, record and do the right things at the right time. So a lot of effort goes in. The documentaries are going to be hopefully a bit more regular as they go, just a little something. That was my ultimate aim. I want to do some history of the canals and things, just general Victorian Edwardian stuff, because it's what I'm interested in. So that'll be nice as it goes forward. Hopefully his eye, as we see, will remain better. So as long as it stays like that, he's good. But as for me, I am going to go sort out the washing, because I'm having to use all the boat facilities now, £2 a time. It's too much when you're not working, you don't want to spend all your money on washing and stuff, but it is what it is at the minute. So I'm going to get on with that. I've got a few bits to do tonight, and then Monday it's going to be full steam ahead, back on to doing some bits on the boat, and plenty of job interviews and phone calls coming up. So hopefully this night, I'm not too bothered about being out of work in the minute. It's a really nice extended break considering the shite that I went through in one job to another. It's just good. I think hotels have definitely lost their way. They can say what they like to me, but they just have. If you look at the jobs on the job sites like Indeed, etc. If you look at an assistant restaurant manager on the high street, like just a standalone restaurant, they will pay £7,000 or £8,000 a year more than you are getting as a general manager of a restaurant in a hotel, even a graded, you know, awarded restaurant. So the wages are just better. And I've applied for museums and theatre and different things that I had to kind of a work connection through the years in the hospitality roles, because you know what? They're paying more. And I don't care if I demote myself, because at one point I was deputy general manager. If I have to demote myself now to assistant restaurant manager, so be it. Cost of living's gone through the roof, thank you government. So why the hell not? Just, I'm not bothered about position at this point. Just earn some more money, have a better job, less responsibility, less stress. Why not? Makes sense. So that's that. I might do a little political one as well coming up in the week, because there's some things going on about over the last few weeks, conscription and the state of the country and everything. One thing I can comment on is conscription to the military. So there's been a lot of fear-mongering in the press. So I'm going to drop a little my take on all that kind of roundup of the news of the last week, because I sat watching loads of stories. Because believe it or not, I keep out of the world. I don't know what's going on out there. It's only because of YouTube. I've come across a few of the videos and said, oh, this and all this. I didn't know any of this was going on. So watch out for that. It'd be interesting, my take on it. But I'm going to go now, get on with some stuff. See you in the next one. Sorry, it's another one of those compiled bits and pieces just for the things people are asking for. See you later.